Hello, good morning and good afternoon, and welcome to my part of this webinar, using data tables and XPages. First, some facts about me. My name is Oliver Busse. I'm doing Node since the year 2000. I am an IBM champion for ICS in 2015. I'm an active OpenNTF contributor and currently a board member. I'm doing XPages every day. I love frameworks, especially Bootstrap, and I'm also a teacher and a student all the time, every day in my work life. And beside coding, when I'm not using a PC, no, that's not right. When I'm not coding on my PC, I'm using a PC for music production. And I also like to drum a bit on my drum kit. So what will you learn from me within the next minutes? I'm basically showing you the usage of the DataTables jQuery plugin for using it in your XPages application to display your structured data within structured data tables, HTML tables, to look very nice and to feel very comfortable. The key part is the implementation in your existing XPages application. There are some basics you have to follow, and there are some caveats and workarounds you have to keep in mind, and I will show you the workarounds with that plugin. And in addition, I show you what data sources you can use. You can use static data sources computed via an XPage, or dynamic data sources read via an REST service. And the webinar will conclude with a summary of what can you do and what you can't do with the plugin. So what is DataTables? DataTables is just another jQuery plugin, an open source jQuery plugin. It runs with jQuery core only. You don't need the jQuery UI library for it to run. It also runs with the latest extension library from OpenNTF, which contains also the Bootstrap responsive design, and therefore jQuery is also implemented with the latest extension library. If you don't want to use the latest extension library, or you cannot use the extension library, you can maybe use the Bootstrap for XPages plugin, also from OpenNTF, to get this running. The Bootstrap for XPages plugin comes with the jQuery core library as well, and of course the Bootstrap framework itself. The DataTables plugin is not a bootstrappy plugin, but it can be enhanced to work with the Bootstrap responsive design and the CSS that comes with the Twitter Bootstrap CSS core library. I will show you that in the demo. So what do you have to do to implement the plugin, the DataTables plugin, to your application? Of course, you have to download the sources. But before you download the sources, you might want to have a look at the datatables.net homepage for additional documentation, for demonstration and examples. This is a great homepage and a great resource for getting started with this genius plugin. The second URL points to the GitHub repository where you can clone or download the source code and the whole JavaScript stuff you have to implement in your application. So the basic implementation is to download the stuff and drag the content, it's usually a folder you download, into your web content folder in your NSF. And then create a theme, maybe, and link the JS and CSS files, or just link the JS and CSS files on the XPages you want to use the plugin on. This is one way. I want to show you a smarter way to download the stuff and implement it in your XPages app. But before we start to implement it, I want to show you the homepage of this plugin. It's called http://datatables.net. This is what it looks like. And as you can see, there are a lot of examples displayed here just to play around with and just to get a feeling how this plugin will work. You see sorting options and paging options and stuff, search options. You can see there's a filter option here. It's so great. And if you read the documentation, follow the examples, it will lead you to some styling options. And this demonstration, I will use an XPages application, which is Bootstrap enabled. As I said, I am a Bootstrap fan. I'm a Bootstrap addicted. And my applications are mostly designed and styled with the Bootstrap framework. So this plugin also comes with the Bootstrap styling option. I will show you to implement that later in my demo. To get you an idea of the power and the possibilities of this plugin, I will just point out the so-called fixed column extension. This plugin comes with several extensions. As you can see, there's autofill and fixed header and key table and responsive design and stuff. But I just want to point out a very cool extension. It's called fixed columns. The fixed columns extension allows you to position the first column as a static one in your table. The header row is always static. You can see your data table, which has a header, is displayed with a static header, so you can scroll through your data without losing the focus of your data headers. With this extension of the fixed columns, you can also keep the data static in the first column, so you can scroll in that way through your data and in both directions. This is pretty cool. So, with that being said, you just want to download it, right? You can find the download options here on that homepage. And this download page will give you several ways to download the whole data table sources, even if you want to implement the whole stuff, the data tables plugin itself and the extensions individually via the CDN resources. But you also can use the download link here that points to the GitHub repository. The GitHub repository looks like this. The GitHub repository can be found under datatables/datatables in GitHub. So just clone or download the zip file to your desktop. Another way to implement the whole stuff to your application is something I want to show you also, as this makes everything really simple. So for this way, I have to show you some of the blog entries of the Yellowsphere community. I just found really, really exciting and helpful. It's from Frank van der Linden, and he posted it a while ago, September last year. How to use the bar for XPages. Don't get me wrong, this isn't a plugin or something. This is just a way to really do an implementation of an external library or source code on your XPages application on a really smart way. This has nothing to do with the plugin DataTables itself. It's a general way to implement external libraries into your XPages stuff in your NSF structure. Go to that URL and follow the instructions are given here. I will show you the live demo right now with a blank application. So I switched to a really blank application just to show you the power of Bower. Really nice rhyme. The power of Bower. What is Bower? Bower is a so-called package manager for the web. If you're not familiar with what a package manager is, just read this page and you will get into it really fast. And this will make your life so much easier to implement external libraries for your web applications, especially when you're using XPages and the Domino Designer. So there are some prerequisites here to use Bower. You need to run on your machine where your development starts. You need to run the Node.js framework. So this is another buzzword and another keyword here, but I strongly recommend you to have a look into Node.js. This is the homepage. Just click on the install button and just follow the instructions. It will install a runtime on your machine. It's not that much of megabytes or something. Just leave it on your machine and you will love it. Okay. Node.js is just a server side, a back end, a JavaScript interpreter that can run a whole bunch of commands to make your life easier. If you once installed Node.js, you are able to run Bower. Maybe you have to restart your machine after installing Node.js. After installing Node.js, you are able to install Bower right from the command line. Just open a command line on Windows and such as this one and type that npm install g Bower stuff. Bower will install itself within Node.js, and after closing and restarting the command line, any command line you like, you are able to run Bower to install a package. So, what I'm talking about? I'm talking about DataTables, right? DataTables is a plugin and the source code can be downloaded via GitHub. Everything that can be downloaded via GitHub, maybe, it's not always the fact, but maybe in this case it is the fact, you can download it and install it with all dependencies, and that's the key part. You can install the whole plugin DataTables with all the dependencies you need for this to run with Bower, as Bower is a package manager. If you are familiar with Linux, then you know what a package manager is. A package manager is for downloading and installing and setting up dependencies for the software you are about to install. And this is so great. So to give you an idea what I'm talking about, I just opened or created a new and blank database on my Domino Designer. If you have not the Navigator view open or the Package Explorer visible here, just run it from the window Show Eclipse Views menu and open the Package Explorer or the Navigator. I prefer the Package Explorer. The database that I opened in the application Navigator here is also displayed here in this. So to use Bower and the cool feature of installing plugins, add-ons, source code, what else, via a package manager directly into your XPages application, you have to enable source control for your application. So if you're not familiar with using source control within Domino Designer, and I strongly recommend you some of the episodes of Notes in 9, of David Leedy's Notes in 9 that deal with source control. So, to be short, source control activation for an for a Notes database is just creating a local folder on your disk and a name of a project you can define for yourself and just use it where you want, and this will show you, and this will create a local and a folder structured file system dependent equivalent of your Notes database, but in the file system. So the compact NSF stuff will be exported to the disk. So I do this. I open my Explorer. I navigate to this folder I just created, go to the web content folder, and I open a command line here. And I now just type Bower install DataTables, for example. DataTables, it's just a keyword that is used for that repository I'm talking about. And as you can see, Bower will search for a lot of stuff here. And it will search the repository of GitHub in this case, and it will find, hopefully it will find, the dependency definition. And now you can see it downloaded something in that folder called Bower Components. This is a hard-coded name in this case, and there's the data tables stuff, and there's also the jQuery stuff. So this is quite a cool to implement, to read the back in your Notes application, just switch to your Domino Designer and say sync with on this project. So this will be a part of your on disk project. I have to refresh it here and I have to sync it again. Refreshing the project is necessary here. And as you can see, it's now part of our NSF component. Pretty cool, huh? So forget about all that demo of the Bower stuff. This is just a way to get the whole source code into your application. Of course, you can use the default download zip stuff and just drag and drop it into your application. This is where my demo starts, with the demo application and a view to the structure of the DataTables demo NSF. As you can see, I used that way before to implement the data tables components into my NSF. This is not the demo I just showed you. This is the data tables NSF nodes database residing on my local server. And within the web content folder, I have a Bauer components folder, which is created, was created by the Bauer installer. This one. And here's the data tables main folder and some extensions, all extensions, to be honest. And some media, and it's downloaded the JavaScript files and the CSS files. As this plugin comes with some styling. So my first step is to create a theme for implementing all the necessary JavaScript and CSS files. I created a theme here. It's called DataTables. This theme is used and defined in the XSP properties here. This theme is using another theme here as my demo application depends on my Bootstrap 3 enabled template. And this theme implements the whole data tables plugin resources, the CSS file, and the JS files. And in this case, as I use the Bootstrap styling here, the special Bootstrap data tables resources to get the look and feel of Bootstrap for the formatted table. I also added some CSS and JS resources for the extension I showed you before for the static column. This is the extension called fixed column. Now the first column that is shown in the demo before. So with that sources enabled, I can now show you the implementation of my XPages application. First, you can download and find this demo application, the whole sources, ready to run with the plugin, the Bootstrap layout and stuff on my GitHub repository. I will show you the link to it at the end of this demo. The application itself utilizes some of the plugins from OpenNTF. It uses the XPages extension library. It must not be the latest version. It will also run with the extension library that ships with Domino 9.901. But it uses the Bootstrap for XPages plugin. As I pointed out on the presentation before, this plugin will run with either the extension library or the Bootstrap for XPages plugin. And for some backend stuff, I'm utilizing the OpenNTF Domino API. This is also optional. You can also run your application or even this application without using the OpenNTF Domino API, but I strongly recommend you to use the Domino API from OpenNTF. I don't want to go in detail here why you should use it, but the main reason for me to use it is I can use notes objects without giving a damn about recycling notes objects such as views, documents, or databases. So this demo starts at the homepage, and the homepage displays a static HTML table here, displaying some data. The HTML used here is shown below. This is just a simple table element and consists of the main parts, a t-head and a t-body. I have to point out that the DataTables plugin will run only if you style or create your tables with a valid th head and a valid th body DOM element. So this table shown here consists of a th head and a th body. The styling of the table is not shown in this HTML markup example here, but utilizing the Bootstrap table CSS classes, table hover and stuff. So this table is not using the DataTables plugin, but I can turn it on via this button. This button is calling a JavaScript, a client-side JavaScript. And the client-side JavaScript is shown here. The button turns a script called initTable. InitTable runs this single line of code referring to that table, which has the ID table simple, refers to table simple and applies the plugin with that call of the data table function here. So if I click the button, this script is applied to that static HTML table. Watch it. Wow! Something happens here. The plugin modifies the static HTML table, adds some DOM elements here, the combo box and that HTML markup here, and the search input box and the pager and the info message here below showing 1, 2, 3 or 3 entries, blah 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 blah, and gives you the possibility to sort the entries ascending, descending, right on your fingertips. These are just 3 entries, but this is so cool. With this one line achieved, right? So if we take a look into the source code, the index.html, this is a table itself displayed in the browser. Somewhere there's a button. Here's a button. And this button only says init table with client-side JavaScript. Init table is just a function in a script block defined at the beginning of this page. It just shows the code you've already seen on my demo webpage. So I've reload the page again. It reloads the static HTML table. I can use the button again to format and to apply the plugin to that table once again. Be careful. You can't apply the plugin a second time to the same table. The plugin will verbose error message like this as a message box. This is some kind of annoying, but if you know this, you are able to deal with it and do not call this JavaScript method, this initialization method, twice or a second time. Okay, this is the static HTML table. My second demo page uses a computed HTML table. As you can see, there are several entries displayed in a static HTML table. This page uses a simple repeat control to read data from a nodes view, a simple nodes view. The table starts here, and this is a repeat, and the repeat control uses a data source called view 1. The data source view 1 is defined on the XPages level here, and I'm using a sample data set here, and it's a fake names data set you may know. It's containing about 1300 entries of fake names with email addresses and addresses and zips and cities and credit card data and so on. And this view is displayed with that repeat control. I did not use any view panel here in this demo, and I did not use a data table control, the general XPages data table control here, because the view panel and the data table control do not use the structure needed for this plugin. In that case, the T head and the T body parts of the markup. You have to make sure your markup is using the TH, the T head and the T body structure like this. This repeat control repeats the view entries, and it displays 100 entries per page. So if I turn the plugin on this computer table, you can see it shrinks down the markup that is displayed. You can see the default number of entries is limited to 10. And this page below is computed by the plugin. So I'm still having 100 entries in this page, and I have 10 pages to page through within that 100 entries. And I can also search within that entries. Pretty neat. The plugin gives you an option to change the number of entries displayed here. I can switch to 25 or even 100, so there is no paging at all. This is only one page, as there are 100 entries displayed. This is computed HTML. Now what if you want to page your data sources on an XPages level? The paging is usually generated with the XPages itself. You are used to display view data on your XPages and a page through the data. Of course, you can do it with a plugin too, but there's one limitation. In this case, this X page displays just 10 entries per XPages page. I hope you understand me. This paging is done on an XPages level. It's not done via the plugin. That's because I display the pager above and not at the bottom. This pager comes from the XPages. I will show you that. Paging. On that X page, I have another repeat. This is a repeat and it displays only 10 rows at a time. And there's a pager, an X pages pager, paging through all the pages from that repeat control. Repeat one, repeat two, repeat one. Okay. The goal is to have the DataTables plugin activated even if I page through each X pages repeat page control. In that case, the repeat control displays 10 entries. I page through the 10 entries, another 10 and another 10 and so on. But I want to have the plugin applied to the table rendered by this repeat control. So just have a look at this. This is just a simple trick. I have the pager and the pager uses the partial refresh. And the partial refresh runs for the repeat control. The repeat control is defined here. The repeat control starts here and the repeat control ends here. The script block that initializes the DataTables plugin is defined outside of the repeat control. No problem. So if you have a pager applied to something that repeats your data and displays your data, there's no problem with it as long as you call your script afterwards. So every time I page through the repeat controls page, the DataTables plugin is applied to the table markup the repeat control generates. There is one disadvantage here. As I display only 10 entries in this case, I can only sort those entries, 10 entries in this case, not all entries. Look at it, at this sorting option. If I page to this next page, the sorting option is gone. Okay. Maybe you can find a solution for that. I didn't find it yet, but as you can see, the markup itself is working. So also the search just working for the entries that are displayed on that page. If I am going to a page that displays entries like this, I can find them. If I just jump on the first page, other entries are found when I use the search and the filter option here. So this is the disadvantage using static data and the XSP, the XPages controls and structures for paging through data. Another option can be using REST data. I'm not going to deep dive into what is REST and what is and what should it look like. REST is just a service you can call from your server via client-side JavaScript to call some backend functionality to deliver data in this case JSON format. If you're not familiar with REST data and what is REST is, I strongly recommend you to read about it. I can only show you how this DataTables plugin is working with REST data. This page shows all the data of my database, all the names. You can see there are 10 items displayed in that table, and I can page through 130 pages right now. But this paging is done via client-side JavaScript, not server-side JavaScript. It's not a pager from XPages, it's the pager from the plugin. It looks like the server-side pager, but the styling only comes from the bootstrap CSS. So the whole data of the whole dataset is read by the plugin and can be paged through and searched. Of course, I can search my name here. Here it is. My name is not on the first page. My name is somewhere on the, I don't know, somewhere else. Here it is on the 16th page. Okay, but I can find it. I can find it within the data that is read through the REST service. So, to enable the plugin to read data from a REST service, just have a look at the documentation and you will find the option called AJAX. The AJAX requires an URL to a REST service. This URL displayed here points to a REST service control on my XPages called REST XSP/data. So if I copy that URL and use it in the browser, I will get the REST response from my Domino server. You can see this is in JSON format, and the JSON is structured. It's having a data object here, and displaying all the entries, all 1300 entries right here, from all the names in the database, and each data entry consists of a key value pair. In this case, the key is a string and the value is also a string. The key value pairs has to be named in the columns attribute of the plugin call. You can see data is the root element of my REST response. And here you can find all the fields that should be displayed in my data table. There is also a value called unID with an option visible false. This data component is not displayed in my data table, but it's still here. Here it is. In that case, this field is used to compute an URL, which is used to open the document when double-clicking on an entry on the data table. So you have to define your REST URL, and you have to define all the columns that should appear in your data table when using REST data with that plugin. So if I double click on an entry here, I compute the URL via JavaScript, client-side JavaScript, to open the document. In that case, a static URL which opens the XPage displaying the contact information and with a URL parameter needed to display and open the document. Oops. So before I show you what to tweak when implementing the DataTables plugin, I want to show you another option I created in my demo application you can also use, and this is called Dynamic View. The Dynamic View allows you to display every view in your application restricted to the paging of your client-side application. The paging which is used here is directly from the plugin and not from the XPages paging. So there's one caveat here. If you want to use the dynamic view control, you have to make sure your data is not too expensive. In this case, I load 1300 documents via the REST service. The REST service is part of the dynamic view control. The REST service is computed from a view U name when using it. The dynamic view control computes also every column in that view you are using. And if you are using a greater number of documents, maybe 10,000 or 100,000 of documents, the loading of that page will take much longer. That's one disadvantage of using a REST service, because the response for the former short JSON response is much greater the more documents you are using in your view. So if I want to customize this view control, I turn to my dynamic view XPage. The custom control uses a property. This case is using by name. It has to be a view in your database. First I used by city, now I'm using by name. I reload the page, and the control reads now from that given view. And as you can see, it takes a little bit longer then. And there's also a lot of more data displayed per page in this case. So it's only 10 entries displayed. There's a scroll bar because of the line breaks here. And if I display 100, the amount of data displayed is growing. But you can also page, and you are paging client-side. There's no load on the server. Finally, I created a demo for the usage of the one of the extensions of the static column. In this case, this first column is static. The header is also static, but the first column is static. You can scroll through your data and the first column stays in on the page static, and you can scroll through your data. This is also using a REST service here, and it looks pretty neat. And sometimes it's important to show the first column here. Okay. From the demo right to implementation. The implementation has some caveats. The DataTables plugin itself comes with JavaScript files. The JavaScript files are the resources we want to have a closer look to. The plugin itself does not have any caveats. You can use the DataTables.js or the DataTables.min.js, which is the minified version of the JavaScript. You can implement it without any tweaks. I experienced problems when implementing extensions like the fixed column extension. Of course, you want to implement a minified version of the JavaScript file, but as you have to tweak the source JavaScript for that extension, you may want to not use the minified one. You may want to use the normal, the debuggable one. There are some problems regarding JavaScript files with modern plugins. Modern plugins use the so-called AMD. It's an acronym for asynchronous module definition, which means nothing more than please browser load this plugin if the page requires the plugin. This kind of behavior is what Dojo also uses. Dojo, the built-in Dojo with our Domino server. And therefore, the AMD behavior interferes with the Dojo behavior. So modern plugins are not able to be loaded to our XPages when using in conjunction with Dojo. So there are several workarounds. The best way is to turn off AMD behavior in the plugins JavaScript, if there is a way. For example, this one, the fixed column JS script file, this is the extension for the fixed column, uses the AMD way at the bottom. Scroll to the bottom of the source code. In my source code, you can figure out I commented out some lines to disable the AMD behavior here. I'm just using the native jQuery factory behavior of adding and loading the module at runtime. So there are several blog posts about disabling AMD behavior, and there are also Stack Overflow answers and other workarounds, but I prefer to modify the behavior in the JavaScript sources directly. So it is with the bootstrap styling stuff in this case. To get this running, and if you experience problems when loading external plugin resources, not only data tables but every other resources like moment.js or other libraries, then first try to figure out how to disable the asynchronous module data loading styling of that plugins. And regarding XPages, there's another problem. I switch to my slides now. The XPages default behavior should be using the runtime optimized resources activated in your XSP properties. So if I show you the XSP properties, you should activate that checkbox here to aggregate every resource, CSS resource, JavaScript resource and stuff, from your sources in your XPages app to be read at one time. If you don't know what resource aggregation is, please have a look into the documentation. If you want to use it, and I strongly recommend you to use it because it narrows the impact of your to your Domino server, by loading smaller resources, then you may face troubles with plugins such as DataTables, and in this case with CSS files. The CSS files that are used define the images for the sorting options. I mean those arrows in the table headers here, those little images. Those little images are defined in the CSS. I don't use the minified CSS because it's very hard to find the definitions here. I'm using the unminified, the normal CSS here. And I just had a look, had to search about, for those image resources that are used here. When you're using the default plugin without any bootstrap styling or something, you have to tweak the URLs for the image resources of that datatables jQuery datatables CSS resources. These are the URLs that point to a relative URL to the image resources. You have to tweak them. In my demo, I'm using the bootstrapped version of that resources. In that case, I had to tweak the URLs to a absolute URL. The relative URL does not work with resource aggregation well at this point. Maybe IBM will find a fix for it. If you turn off resource aggregation in your properties, switching off that checkbox, everything goes well. But I strongly recommend you to use it. I'm using the Bootstrap CSS file instead of the default DataTables CSS file, and I had to tweak those URLs to an absolute path to the image resources. In this case, there are only five of them, both ascending, disabled, and descending, disabled. And now it works. So please don't use the minified CSS when you have to tweak those definitions. Just use the unminified ones. If you use the default data tables URLs, then please tweak the relative URLs pointing and starting with that double dot slash URL here to the absolute path where your resources reside. In this case, in this folder. And you are done. Okay, that was my demo and my implementation of the DataTables plugin in XPages. If you are interested and you want to play around with my application from this demonstration for yourself, please feel free to open that URL, clone it to your desktop, download it, and contribute if you like. If you have other ideas and extensions, additions to that simple demo, please let me know. If you need any help or have any question, contact Team Studio or TLCC, or just in case, drop me a note, tweet me. I'm using Twitter a lot, and or just leave a comment on the corresponding blog post regarding data tables on the URL shown here. So thank you for watching, and bye bye.